Hello, Dr. Jakinayak. My name is Mahind Kumar, and I am by qualification MBA and work for Thomas Cook at Fort. My question is regarding non-vegetarian foods. It is allowed in Islam. Animals are living beings. So don't you think that it is violence? And my second question is that, is it compulsory in Islam to have non-veg food, and can a pure vegetarian person can follow Islam?
Mr. Mahesh Kumar has asked a very good question. He said that in Islam, you all have non-veg food, you all kill animals. Why does Islam give permission to kill living creatures? And can a Muslim be a pure vegetarian? Brother, before I answer the question, I'd like to tell you, a Muslim can be a very good Muslim even by being a pure vegetarian. It is not compulsory in Islam that you should have non-veg food. It's not compulsory. But since Allah says in the Quran and gives permission for a person to have non-veg food, in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 1, it says that eat of the four-footed animals which have been made lawful for you. It's mentioned Surah Nahl, chapter 16, verse number 5, that you can eat the meat of the cattle. It's mentioned Surah Mu'minun, chapter 23, verse number 21, that in the cattle, we give you a drink which is good for the humankind, and of the meat you can eat. So when Almighty God gives you permission to eat the meat of the lawful animals, then why should we not have? Now coming to the logical reason why Islam permits you to have non-veg food. If we analyze non-veg food, it's rich in protein. The human body, it requires 23 amino acids, out of which 8 are not made in the human body. It should be given by external diet, which are known as essential amino acids. Now these all 8 essential amino acids are present in no kind of vegetable food together. It's only present in flesh food. So the non-veg flesh food is more nutritious as compared to vegetables. Furthermore, if you analyze, if you see the set of teeth of the herbivorous animals, the cow, the goat, the sheep, they have got flat set of teeth. They only have vegetables, they don't have flesh food. If we analyze the set of teeth of the carnivorous animals, the tiger, the leopard, the lion, they have got pointed set of teeth. They have canine set of teeth. They only have flesh, they don't touch vegetables. If you analyze the set of teeth of the human beings, if you go in the mirror and see, we human beings, we have got flat teeth as well as pointed teeth. If Almighty God wanted us to have only vegetables, why did he give us this canine teeth? Why did he give us this pointed teeth? For what? But naturally, to have non-veg food, to have the flesh food. Furthermore, if we analyze the digestive system of the human being, if you compare it to the herbivorous animals, cow, goat, sheep, they can only digest vegetables. The digestive system of the carnivorous animals, tiger, leopard, lion, they can only digest flesh food, they cannot digest vegetables. The digestive system of the human beings can digest both. It has small intestine, big intestine. It can digest vegetables as well as flesh food. It can digest both. So if Almighty God wanted us to have only vegetables, why did he give us a digestive system which can digest both? As far as you analyze, many of the Hindus think that Hinduism prohibits the eating of flesh food. In fact, if you read, it's mentioned Manusmriti, chapter number 5, verse number 30. Almighty God has created some animals to eat and some to be eaten. If you eat the animals that have been created to be eaten, then it's not a sin. Manusmriti, chapter number 5, verse number 31 says that Almighty God created some animals for sacrifice. Killing them is not a sin. Manusmriti, chapter 5, verse number 40 says that killing sacrificial animals for sacrifice is permitted. It is a law of the God. So in Hindu scriptures, it's permitted to have non-veg food. If you read the Vedas and the other scriptures, sages and sons, they ate non-veg food, they even ate beef. If you read Mahabharata, Anushasan Parv, chapter number 88, when the Pandavas, they gather, Yudhishthir, who is the eldest brother of the Pandav, he asks Bhishma that what food should we give in yagna, in puja, in sacrifice, so that our ancestors will be satisfied. So Bhishma replies that If you give herbs and shrubs and vegetables, our ancestors will be satisfied for 1 month. If you give them fish, for 2 months. If you give them meat, for 3 months. If you give them hair, for 4 months. If you give them goat, for 5 months. If you give them bacon, for 6 months. If you give them birds, for 7 months. If you give them deer, for 8 months. And the menu continues, big menus there. It says if you give buffalo, for 11 months. If you give the flesh of cow, our ancestors will be satisfied for 1 full year. And if you give red meat of goat or meat of rhinoceros, they'll be satisfied inexhaustibly. So according to Hindu scriptures, eating non-veg is not a sin. It is because many of the Hindus were being influenced by the Ahimsa philosophy of not killing any living creatures. They started accepting it. But even this philosophy of Ahimsa, as you said, that killing living creature is a sin. Brother, do you know that even plants have got life? Do you know that, brother?
Yes.
So if you say killing living creature is a sin, killing a plant is also a sin. So why do you have plants?
Agreed.
Very good. Furthermore, there are some people who say, okay, brother Zakir, I agree that plants have got life, but the plants can't feel pain. Therefore, killing a plant is a lesser sin as compared to killing an animal. The point to be noted is that today science has advanced and we have come to know even the plants can feel pain. But the cry of the plant cannot be heard by the human being, because human beings hear, the frequency that they hear is from 20 cycles per second to 20,000 cycles per second. Anything below and above this range you cannot hear. So there was a farmer in America who converted the cry of the plant into the human frequency, and you could come to know when the plants were crying, when they wanted water. There's another person who came and argued with me and told me, Brother Zakir, I agree with you that plants have got life, plants can feel pain, but the plants have got about 2 senses less as compared to the animals. Therefore, killing a plant is a lesser sin as compared to killing an animal. I'm asking you the question, brother. Suppose your brother, your elder brother, he is born deaf and dumb. After he grows up, and someone comes and kills him, so will you go and tell the judge, me Lord, give the murderer less punishment because my brother had 2 senses less, he could not hear, he could not speak? Will you say that? In fact, you will say, give the murderer double punishment. He could not hear, he could not speak. My brother was masoom, he was innocent. So in Islam, it does not work like that, 2 senses or 3 senses. The Quran says in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 168, eat of the good things we have provided to you. As long as the food is halal, it's tayyab for you, you can have it. And furthermore, I personally have got no problem if the non-Muslim don't have non-veg. I've got no problem. Only if they tell me eating non-veg is a sin, it's a crime, that's the time I give the reply. Otherwise, if the non-Muslims in India, they don't have non-veg, it's beneficial for me. If all the non-Muslims in India start having non-veg, then the prices of mutton and beef will rise. It'll be more expensive for me to have it. So personally, I've got no problem. Hope that satisfies your question, brother.
Yeah, definitely, sir.
So now, if you want, you can yet be a good vegetarian. If you want, you can eat non-veg also. Eating non-veg will keep you more healthy. You can have, but even if you want to be a pure vegetarian, it's not a sin. Hope that answers the question, brother.